Hello students, welcome in our third session of A Short Monsoon Diary. Students, in this session we are going to see question and answers of this lesson. Okay students, so the first question is, why is the author not able to see Bichu? Why is the author not able to see Bichu? Okay, so the answer is, the author could not see Bichu because of the mist that concealed the hills. He could only hear his voice but could not see him. Okay students, so this is the answers for the question. Look at that question number 2. What are the two ways in which the hills appear to change when the mist comes up? I repeat, what are the two ways in which the hills appear to change when the mist comes up? And the answer is, when the mist comes up, it covers the hills and spreads the silence. So these are the two things that change. Okay students, look at that next question. When does the monsoon season begin and when does it end? How do you prepare to face the monsoon? Students, I will give you the answer of it. The monsoon season in Mussoorie, in that region only, it begins from the June 24th to 25th, and by the August 2nd the people are fed up with the rain. It ends by August 31, then begins the winter rains, which end by the late March. We take out our raincoats and umbrellas to face the monsoon, and like that we will prepare for the monsoon. Okay students, look at that next question. Which hill station does the author describe in diary entry? And it will be the Mussoorie. Okay, then in the next question, for how many days does it rain without stopping? What does the author do on these days? I repeat the question, for how many days does it rain without stopping? And what does the author do on these days? Okay, so the answer is, it rains non-stop for 8 or 9 days. The author keeps the pacing the room and looking out of the window. So on these days, author just keeps out looking out of the window, and he was just pacing in the room. Okay students, then look at that next question. Where do the snakes and rodents like take shelter and why? I repeat, where do the snakes and rodents take shelter and why? The answer is, the rodents and snakes take shelter in a roofs, attics and godowns. They do so because their holes are flooded with the rainwater. So this is the answer of the why rodents and snakes take shelter and where and why. Okay students, then why did the author receive the mail? What did the author receive in the mail? The author received a check in a mail, right students? So look at that next question. Question number 1, from working with the text, page number 118. Look at carefully. For June 24 to 25, August 2 and March 23, now write down the changes that happen as the rain progresses from June to March. Students, I repeat the question. Look at carefully the diary. The entries of the diaries from June 24 to 25th, then August 2nd and March 23. You have to write the changes that happens between this period from June to March. Okay, and the answer is, rains in Mussoorie begins in June and ends by the March. June 24th is the first day of monsoon mist, which covered the hills and spreads silence. On August 2nd, it rained all night and made sleeping difficult. By late March, ends winter as well as the rains. So this is the story and this is the period of rain in Mussoorie. Okay. Question number 2. Why did the grandmother ask the children not to kill the chuchundar? Why did the grandmother asks the children not to kill the chuchundar? And the answer is, The grandmother told the children not to kill the Chuchundas because they brought good luck and money. It is like a superstition, student, but the answer is they brought good luck and money. Therefore, grandmother told children not to kill the Chuchundras. Okay. Then question number 3. What signs do we find in nature which show that the monsoon are about to end? I repeat the question. What signs do we find in nature which show that monsoons are about to end? Then the answer is, by the end of the monsoon, the greenery is at its peak. By the end of the monsoon, the greenery is at its peak and the seeds of the cobra lily turn red, a rainbow is formed in the sky. So these are the signs which shows us the monsoon is about to end. Then question number 4, complete the following sentences. Students, you have to just complete the following sentences with the help of our lesson. Here, I have made the answer for you directly. Please watch it. Biju is not seen, but his voice is heard because dense mist covers and hides the hills. So, writer only able to hear his voice, not to see him. Okay. Then, the writer describes the hill station and valleys as a paradise that might have seen. Okay. Then, look at the third one. The leopard was successful in killing a dog, had to flee when the Biju's mother arrived carrying curses, but had to flee when the, look at that next question. The minuets are easily noticed because of their bright colors. The minuets were easily found. Then look at that next one. It looks like a fashion display on the slopes when they are covered by a variety of flowers. Okay. Look at that next one. During the monsoon season, snakes and rodents are found in roofs and attics because their holes are flooded with the water and these places provide them convenient shelter. Okay, and therefore the rodents and snakes were found in roofs and attics. Question number 5. Although tin roofs are given to springing uncountable leaks, there is a feeling of being untouched by and yet in touch with the rain. Why has the writer used the word springing? And the answer is, the word springing is used to show suddenness. With which water starts leaking. Okay. Then next question. Why is the writer untouched by the rain? Because he is inside the room and therefore he became untouched. Then third question. How is the writer in touch with the rain at the same time? Look, the answer, he hears the drumming of rain on the tin roof. Writer continuously hears the drumming of the rain on the tin roof. He also looks out of the window to see the rains and therefore he said that I am in touch but remains untouchable. Okay, then look at that next question. Mention few things that can happen when there is an endless rain for days together. And the answer is, a long spell of rain makes life miserable. One is close up in his room. Everything becomes damp and soggy. Rodents like snakes, insects, and they enter in the house for shelter. So these things happen when there is an endless rain for days together. Okay, question number 7. What is the significance of cobra lily in relation to the monsoon season, its beginning and its end? There is a significance between cobra lily and monsoon. We will see what is it. At first, cobra lily appears with the arrival of monsoon, right? Then when the cobra seeds begin to turn red, when the cobra seeds begin to turn red. It indicates the rains are coming to an end. So this is the significant relation between the monsoon season and cobra lily. Working with language, page number 118, you can see how are some words, sorry, here are some words that are associated with the monsoon. And as many words, write as many words as you can and make a list of it. Can you find the words for these in your languages? Yes, of course, I will show you. Look at that words given: downpour, flood, mist, cloudy, power cuts, cold, and umbrella. So another words that related or associated with the monsoon are rain, water, fog, raincoats, thunder, dampness, lakes, etc. So these are associated words to the monsoon. Students, here in my language I find the alternative words for that are like bauchar, bundabandi, tushar, dhun, sit, chatri, raincoat, andi, adi. So look at that question number 2. Look at that sentence, students. Here is like a part of grammar. Biju wandered into the garden in the evening. Here past tense of wandered is taken. The trees were ringing with a bird song. Here continuous past is taken. So notice the highlighted verbs. Okay, here wandered and were ringing. So the verb wandered tells us that Biju did that evening, means wandered means they do that things on that evening. But the verb was ringing tells us that what was happening continuously at the same time in the past. So that was a continuous past tense. So now look at the sentence below. They tells us about something that happened in the past. They also tells us about the other things that happen continually at the same time in the past. Let's see what are the words or what are the sentence given below. Put the words in the brackets into the proper forms. The first one is done for you. Students, look at that sentences. We into bracket get out of the school bus, the bell dot dot ring, and everyone rush to class. Here we have to use them in a continuous past or past tense. So look at that answers that I have made for you here. Answers: we got out, get become got, means simple past tense. We got out of the school bus, and simultaneously the another thing was going continuously is the bell was ringing and everyone was rush became rushing to class. Okay, so these are the changes. You can use these changes while writing processes. The traffic stop, here the thing was happened before and simultaneously another thing was going on in the past. Some people were sitting on the road and they were shouting slogans. Okay, so these are the changes here. I made them for you. I wore my raincoat. It was raining and people were getting wet. I wore, wear become wore, and was raining, were getting are the changes next to happen. Then she saw a film. She was narrating it to her friends who were listening carefully. Okay, students, you have to just underline the changes that I have given you. Okay, look at that next sentence. We went to the exhibition. Some people were buying clothes while others were playing games. Here go become went and were buying. Then here play become were playing. Then the class was quiet. Some children were reading books and the rest were drawing. Draw become drawing, read become were reading. Okay, students, write all these sentences in your notebook. Then here there is a next question. Question number 3. Here are some words from the lesson which describe different kinds of sounds, and the words are drum, swish, tinkle, cap, and drip. So we have to just match the words with the correct meanings. The first meaning is given. Look at that. To fall in a small drops, it is nothing but drip. Okay, then to make a sound by hitting a surface repeatedly, and it is called as drum. Okay, the third one is to move quickly through the air and making soft sound. It is nothing but swish. Harsh sound made by birds is a caw, and ringing sound of the bell or by breaking glass is a tinkle. Right, students, just write these things in your notebook. Then now fill in the blanks using the correct form of the words given above. The same words you have to use in the given sentences, and you have to fill the blanks. Ramesh dot dot on his desk in impatience. Ramesh drum on his desk in impatience. Then look at that second one. Rainwater dot dot from the umbrella all over the carpet. And the answer is rainwater dripped from the umbrella all over the carpet. The pony dot dot its tail. The pony was swishing its tail. Then the dot dot of breaking glass woke me up. The tinkle of breaking glass woke me up. The caw of the raven disturbed the child's sleep. And like this, you can use them in your own sentences. Okay, look at that question 4. And sure enough, I received a check in the mail. Here, in this case, complete each sentences below by using appropriate phrase from the ones given below. Students, here some phrases are given. Just we will read. Sure enough, colorful enough, serious enough, kind enough, big enough, fair enough, brave enough, foolish enough, and anxious enough. Student, you have to just use them with their proper meaning at the proper place. Look, the first sentence is, I saw thick black clouds in the sky, and dot dot, it soon started raining heavily. And the right answer is, I saw thick black clouds in the sky, and sure enough, it soon started raining heavily. Then second one, the umbrella, the blue umbrella was dot dot for the brother and sister. The blue umbrella was big enough for the brother and sister. Then look at that third one, the butterflies are colorful enough to get notice. Here I use colorful enough, the phrase, for this sentence. Then look at that fourth one, the lady was dot dot to chase the leopard. The lady was brave enough to chase the leopard. So brave enough is the phrase. Then the boy was dot dot to call out to his sister. The boy was anxious enough to call out to his sister. Next one, the man was kind enough to offer help. Here kind enough, I use it for this sentence. The man was kind enough to offer the help. The victim's injury was serious enough for him to get admitted in the hospital. So serious enough is the proper phrase here for this sentence. The victim's injury was serious enough for him to get admitted in a hospital. That person was dot dot to repeat the same mistake again. And here the suitable phrase was, the person was foolish enough to repeat the same mistake again. Okay, students, look at that last sentence. He told me he was sorry and he would compensate for the loss. I said, fair enough. So here the correct phrase is fair enough. Okay, students, look at that next question. Do you believe superstitions? Why or why not? Working with your partner, write down the three superstitious beliefs that you are familiar with. Here you just need to write the different superstitions that you face earlier or you have seen it. Truly speaking, I don't believe in superstitions. These are blind beliefs. The ignorant and conservative people observe them. Superstitions have no specific or scientific base or proof. And here I'm going to give you some superstitions, common superstitions. And the first is 13 is an ominous number. 13. Many people said that it is an ominous number, 13. Then don't start a new project on Saturday. Don't do the work. Don't do the new work on Saturday. It is also superstition. And the third one is stop if black cat crosses your path. I think you might know that. Then look at that question number two. How many different kinds of birds do you come across in the lesson? How many varieties do you see in neighborhood? Are there any birds that you used to see earlier in neighborhood but not now? In group, discuss why you think this is happening. Students, can you tell me how many varieties do you see in your neighborhood? And have you noticed to see earlier some birds but not now? Just discuss. Look at that answer. We come across different kind of birds in this lesson, and these are minivets, dragos, these tree creepers and crows. We see sparrows, pigeons and nightingales in our neighborhood. Earlier we used to see big birds like kites and parrots in our neighborhood, but these have become extinct now. So this is the answer of your question. So here our question and answer session is finished. You should write all the question and answer in your notebook. Thank you.